Okay, so let's begin with this session. There it is recording. Yeah, it is just the regulatory and promotional rules of Reserve Bank of India. Now, if something like this comes, can I start? I didn't ask your permission.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay.
Yes, sir.
Achha. So, okay, chalo, let's start. Whenever this type of question comes, promotional role kya hai, regulatory roles kya hai, what are the objectives, what are the functions, it's definite ki you will get confused. Even I get confused a lot. Okay, promotional rules mein, what was there, and functions, what was there, objectives, what was there. Okay, but just remember 3 to 4 points. Okay, mainly, jaise ki in this regulating volume of currency is can also be a function of RBI. Regulating credit is the function of RBI here, controlling the money and credit. So in this type, just remember the key points. You can explain on your own. Okay, but definitely functions or the role of RBI is important from the exam point of view. Okay, regulatory and promotional roles of Reserve Bank of India is, again, first if I start, regulating the volume of currency. The volume of currency meaning how much cash is there in the bank and outside the bank with the citizens, the hard cash or this cash. So what is available that is also being monitored or regulated by RBI. RBI does this by changing the values in CRR and SLR, or it does it by open market operations or by floating treasury bills, buying back treasury bills, and what are all those things which I'm talking about. I'll do it in later part of the slides or maybe in the next class. What are the treasury bills? What are open market operations? CRR and SLR, you have an idea. Okay, so it regulates the volume of currency. Why the volume of regulation of this is important? Because if there is a lot of currency in the market, then inflation will increase, because a lot of supply of money, so the price of the products will start increasing, because the people will have much more money to spend on the products. So if many people come in to buy the products, the price of the products will rise, and eventually the inflation. Okay, and if the volume of currency is going very slow, very less volume is there of currency, then the stagflation will be there. Okay, people will not have any much money to buy, to go out in the market and buy. So it can be a stagflation or a recession also can occur if volume of currency is very low. So it regulates the volume of currency. Similarly, it regulates credit also. Okay, the people should not take too much loan, not too less, not very less loan. It have a control on commercial banks. Okay, all the commercial banks come under RBI from the nationalization policy, or many of the banks come under SBI and its associates, State Bank of Maharashtra, State Bank of Mysore, State Bank of Travancore, State Bank of many State Bank, all comes under now SBI, State Bank of India. Then there are nationalized bank and there are private banks which come. So all these consist of commercial banks. Then they determine the monetary and the credit policy. Okay, again a kind of a repetition. And then mobilizing savings. In mobilizing savings, Reserve Bank is of the thought or point that, mobilizing savings is, Reserve Bank is of the point that each and every person in the country should have at least one bank account, so that his money or her money should be utilized in the economy. It should not be kept as a cash in the locker of his or her home. Okay, it should not just be lying around in the wallet. Okay, that money should be floating. That money should be floating in the economy. So that's why Reserve Bank of India started a new initiative. It was a new initiative at that time, regional rural banks. So even in a small village where only 50 families are residing, still even in this, even in those kind of small villages, there were a bank, okay, a nationalized bank was established, so that even rural people could get benefit directly, which the government is passing on to them. So there should be no middlemen. If government is passing any benefit to the weaker section or the rural people, and then it should directly be transferred to their bank account, nor passed on through the intermediary. So that's the reason mobilizing savings also and passing on the benefits also. Both the things are there. Then next is institutional credit to agriculture. Okay, again, agricultural loans. Then specialized financial institutions. it promoted RBI promoted the non-banking financial companies. Okay, these are the companies, non-banking financial companies. They are not banks. Okay, they are non-banking definitely, but they are financial companies. They help companies or people to raise finance or to arrange somewhere. People cannot open account in that NBFCs, and there is no savings or fixed deposits cannot be there in that NBFCs. They help in raising the finance. Okay, the detail about the NBFCs we are going to deal in third module. Then chalo, the next is security to depositors. Okay, this is also a quite important role. If the depositors, if they feel secure while putting their money into the bank, then only then they will go to the bank and put their money. Okay, if they don't have that confidence whether my money is safe or not in the banking system, then they would keep away from the bank. Okay, so security to depositors is the role which the RBI plays. Then advisory functions to the government as well, also to the banks and to the citizens, and other policy support also the RBI does. So this is the regulation and promotion roles of RBI. So after this, we are done with RBI. Okay, we started with the objectives, roles, functions, and promotional and regulatory roles. So you just need to imagine whenever you're thinking about RBI, imagine that as a big brother of the entire country who controls the monetary policy, and all the financial transaction is under the RBI's control. It's not RBI is watching every transaction, but it is happening with the rules and regulation which is being formulated by the RBI. Okay, we'll just go through the website of RBI, how it looks like. Okay, so this is the homepage of Reserve Bank of India. Okay, so any updates on monetary policy or anything, you will get it here. The monetary policy, what is the overview, what are the statements, notifications, or all this, you can browse through it. The preamble is there. Okay, what it is actually meant for, what RBI is actually meant for. Then important thing is, you see here, current rates. So before I start with this, any doubts in the theory, this or this? Any doubts? Chat mein bata do. Okay. Chalo, cool. Okay, this is quite important. Current rates. You can see here policy rates. Policy repo rates is there. Okay, the rate at which, again, this is there in the further part of the module, but repo rate is the rate at which a normal commercial bank borrows money from RBI. Okay, I've told you in the previous class, I've told you if a depositor comes to Federal Bank, all of you want to pay the fees and you want to withdraw your money from the Federal Bank, and the Federal Bank doesn't have money, it will ask to other banks, to Kotak and ICICI. If they doesn't have money, then it finally goes to RBI. Okay, so at what rate the RBI will give, this is the rate of interest, the repo rate, at which the commercial bank will get loan from RBI. Reverse repo rate is the reverse thing. Sometimes RBI doesn't have money. Okay, so RBI also asks money from other commercial banks. So during that time, this is the reverse repo rate. So definitely if RBI is asking, it is giving less interest rate. Okay, so that is the interest rate. Margin rate, I'll do it later on. Okay, then bank rate also, I'll do it later on. Okay, so these are the four important policy rates. Then next is reserve ratio, CRR. Cash reserve ratio, which I explained to you, SLR, statutory liquidity ratio. So this is the present one. Last time we did. Okay, wait. I'll next. Last time we did that. This example, if you remember, Federal Bank had 100 crore as a deposits. Okay, from that 100 crores, it cannot utilize all the 100 crores. It needs to give 4% as CRR to RBI, and 21% should invest in some securities, which has been advised by RBI as SLR. And remaining 75 crores, it can utilize however they want. Okay, under the purview of RBI and the regulations. But it is their money. It's kind of their money. Okay, so that this 3 to 4, this 4% or 21%, which I have told you, it is actually as of today, it is 3% as CRR. That means Federal Bank, who is having 100 crores of rupees, need to give 3 crores of rupees with RBI as CRR, and needs to invest 18% from that, all the deposits, all the 100 crores into some securities. So this is what CRR and SLR, and this terminology is very important. If you have taken even core HR subjects, you don't know anything about finance, still you need to remember, because I'll not name them. Now, two of your seniors had an interview, marketing interview. 99% questions were of marketing, but as they were having a dual specialization as finance, ek HR finance tha aur ek dusra marketing finance tha. So both of them were asked this, had been asked by the interviewer, what is, you have taken finance as the second specialization, what is the CRR? What do you mean by CRR? Okay, what do you mean by, just tell me the meaning of it, don't tell me the percentage. So these kind of terminologies, just you remember. Okay, you never know in what interview it will be asked, because it is kind of a general knowledge. Okay, then exchange rates are there, lending or deposit rates are there, all these base rate savings, yes sir. So as and when I'll proceed with the module and proceed with the second module as well, so I'll keep on coming back here, and I'll live show you what is the saving deposit, what is called as base rate, what is MCLR, what are the market trends, what is GSEC securities, government securities kya hai, what are T bills. Okay, this is, we'll do the theory, we'll come here and check. Okay, so next I had planned to do the basic function of commercial banks. Okay, shall I continue or what? I'll take five minutes. Is it fine or tell me kya karne ka? Everyone slept?
No sir.
No sir.
Okay, continue. No, sir. I'll continue.
So continue, sir.
Okay, so just take a brief about. Okay, I'll again go to this page. Okay, I'll give you a structure, how exactly it looks like. I'll open a new one. Okay, here is RBI. Okay, Reserve Bank of India. Aisa kuch hai wo. Okay, so RBI is controlling everyone. So RBI control, how it controls, according to regulation of 1949, Banking Regulation Act. So here is RBI. Under RBI, and according to this provision, there comes the scheduled banks. Okay, SCHEDULD. Okay, I'll not write it. Okay, it comes. There comes scheduled banks. They are called scheduled banks because they are mentioned in the second schedule of this act. Okay, just for theoretical purpose, they are called a scheduled bank. But technically, all the commercial banks, okay, are scheduled banks as of now, because non-scheduled banks are no more are there. It was there before 1991, but as of now, all banks are 99% scheduled banks. Okay, from this scheduled banks. From the scheduled bank, it is divided into scheduled commercial banks and scheduled cooperative banks. Okay, then from this commercial banks, mein there are sector banks, there are private sector banks. Okay, there are foreign banks, and there are finally regional rural banks. Okay, which is there in all of the villages. So public sector, private sector, foreign banks, and regional rural banks. And from this public sector banks, there are nationalized banks and State Bank of India and its associates. And from private sector banks, there are old banks which were there prior to 1991, and there are new private sector banks like ICICI, Kotak. These are new private sector banks. So this is a kind of it is there in notes as well. Okay, don't need to record this. Okay, so in scheduled banks, we have commercial banks and cooperative banks. So commercial banks has been divided up in all these things. So I'm going to talk about commercial banks. Okay, we are not going to talk about what cooperative banks does and what are their roles and what are how they do their job. Okay, we are just going to talk regarding the commercial banks. It includes all the foreign banks, regional rural banks, old banks, new private sector banks, SBI, everyone. Okay, so this is what we are going to do now. Okay, then, yeah. So what are the basic functions? I'll just give an idea. What are the basic functions? Now imagine a bank. You're sitting in a bank. You are a bank manager. For the basic finance, what you know, there are assets and there are liabilities. So even for a bank, there are assets and there are liabilities. Now, how a bank gets an asset? Don't tell me furniture and ye wo sab assets hai. No, the actual assets, the core assets by which the bank can run, all those assets are the deposits. The main asset of any bank by which they can run their banking operation is deposits. Okay, and the liability, okay, the deposits which are there. Okay, now this asset is not the permanent asset. Okay, they will be converted into liabilities, because the people who have deposited money, they will come to bank to withdraw their money. Okay, so technically speaking, in the layman's term, the deposits are termed as liabilities, and the loans and advances which the bank has given to the people are termed as assets. Okay, am I clear? More banking terminology. Okay, I'm not clear. Okay, chalo. This is a bank. Okay, there are assets and there are liabilities. Okay, assets are the loans which the bank has given. Why these are the assets? Because people will come and return these loans. The deposits are the liabilities. Okay, just remember this, how they are converted and noted. You don't remember that. Okay, this is the bank. Assets are the loans, deposits are the liabilities. Okay, and there are kinds of deposits and there are kinds of funds as well. Okay, so when a bank is accepting any deposit, they are divided into three types: savings deposits, time deposit, and current deposits. Saving deposit is the deposits which generally the savings bank account people, the savings bank account holder deposits the money. Okay, time deposits, generally we go open a bank SB account, what we call is a savings bank account. So in SB account, all the savings deposits are deposited. Time deposits are deposits where there is a certain period of time where the deposit will be there, and after that time period gets completed, then the depositor will withdraw all the money. Okay, so the example for this is fixed deposit or recurring deposits. So fixed deposits, there is a time limit, 5 years or 10 years. FD, we call fixed deposits. RD, what we call recurring deposits, it is a time period of maybe 12 months or 18 months, some what time period is there for even for RD. You can continue after that as well, but there is a time limit for that. And current deposits is for the current accounts. Current accounts is also normally what you say, a demand deposits, like savings deposits. But in current account, there is a lot of transaction involved, so there is very less or no interest rate in current deposits. In savings deposits, there is an interest rate which the Kotak gives highest interest rate, 6.5%. Commercial bank I'm talking about, 6.5% to 6.7%. The interest rate is there in savings deposits. In time deposits, it is a FD interest rate, what that has been provided, or recurring deposit interest rate. In current deposits, 0 to 1% is the interest rate. And who opens this current deposit? Generally, the business people or the business account can be a current deposit, because there is a huge transaction and day to day money is being deposited, or day to day money is being withdrawn from that, and the money withdrawal has no limit in that. They can deposit lakhs together, they can withdraw lakhs together, but that is not the case in savings deposits. Generally, in savings deposits, once money is being credited in the account in the starting of in the first day of the month or second day of the month, then only the withdrawal is there till the end of the month. So there is no much of withdrawal or deposit regularly happening. So that's why the money is there with the bank. So that's why bank gives more interest for the savings deposits. Okay. Again, time deposits, it is for a particular period of time, for 5 years or 10 years, like the fixed deposits. So it is there with the bank for 5 years. So bank can utilize the money, invest in some securities or invest in the invest in equity market or debt market, and get some profit out of it. And then after 5 years, again, the money will be brought back into that account and you can withdraw it. Total, all including all these three, it is termed as demand and time liabilities. As I have told you, it is a liability. All these deposits are liabilities. So full form is demand and time liabilities. Time for time deposits, demand are these two deposits, savings deposit and current deposits, are called as demand deposits. Why demand deposits? You can anytime demand your money from the bank, to withdraw your money from the bank. So it is a demand deposit. Time deposits, it is for a particular period of time. So the basic as liabilities for a bank. Okay, so deposits are there. Okay, give me two more minutes. I'll do three more minutes. Give me, then I'll complete this lending of funds. Okay, lending of funds or loans and advances are the assets for the bank. So loans, okay, are advances. Okay, loans and advances, overdraft and discount and purchase bills. Okay, loans and advances are general loans, or the borrower borrows money from bank for any kind of education loan, for agricultural loan, for car loan, for home loan, for business loan. All these loans and advances are done by the bank to some companies, okay, which they require additional money for their working capital, or for running some part of maybe investment activities ke liye sometimes. And so normal loans and advances are there. Then overdraft is the additional withdrawal from the money. Generally, overdraft facility is being given in the current deposits, okay, because the business have opened a account, current account, okay, they are dealing day-to-day transaction at a very large amount, and suppose there is a shortage of money in the current account, still the bank provides them additional money as an overdraft. Okay, for example, there is again 100 lakhs of rupees. Okay, so 1 crore rupees is there by the business in the current account. Okay, and the business requires this 1 crore rupees regularly, and maybe in 3 or 4 days they have withdrawn 50 lakhs, then 40 lakhs. They are left with only 10 lakhs, but they are in the requirement of 20 lakhs for some supply to be paid. So additional 10 lakhs, which has been there, the bank provides them as they have a current account, and the bank has provided some overdraft facility. So that kind of freedom is given by the bank, and this 10 lakhs will be called as the overdraft by that business from that bank. Okay, and then last one is discount and purchase bills. Okay. Discount and purchase bill is, there is a business or a supplier is there of goods, okay, that supplier of goods has delivered the goods to the buyer, and buyer is telling, I need 2 months of credit. That means after 2 months I'll pay the bill. Okay, but now supplier is in need, and they have agreed it. Prior to the supplying of good, supplier had agreed a 2 months credit period I'll give you. So now supplier, after supplying the goods, supplier is in need of money. It has the bill that the depositor will pay. The customer will pay. It has the bill. Now that supplier can go to the bank, give the bill to the bank, and discount that bill, that purchase bill. Okay, what do you mean by discount? That maybe the price of that bill is, again, 10 lakhs of rupees. 10 lakhs of rupees the supplier is yet to get from the customer. Now the supplier is going to the bank and asking bank that you pay me immediately cash as I'm in need of money, and the customer will pay you as the bill is there. So you just need to produce this bill in front of customer, and after 2 months the customer will pay you. Okay. So that bank is taking some commission and giving the supplier the money. Okay, they are definitely not giving them 10 lakhs. They might be giving maybe 9 lakhs or 9.5 lakhs. So 50,000 is the profit for the bank. So that is the discounting of bill. Okay, discounting of bill, like separate concept is there in some of the modules. Okay, again, still any doubts till now? I know I have dealt with all this pretty fast. Okay, any doubts?
No sir.
Okay. As a formality के लिए any doubts? कुछ तो पूछ लोगे.
कुछ doubt नहीं है sir. क्या पूछने का अभी?
हाँ. बहुत dry subject है ना. उसमें भी dry climate भी है Belgium का. ठीक है. This अच्छा. This first two modules are like this, about banks, then from third module onwards it is totally different. It is about the financial services. So zyadatar banks nahi sunoge, starting from third module till sixth module the word bank you will not hear much. But this first module is kind of a general knowledge, because what is RBI and what is CRR, SLR, what is money, what is open market operations, you should have an idea. That's what I was telling you. In any interview, it is kind of a general knowledge for them. CRR nahi pata MBA ka student, SLR nahi pata MBA ka student. And SLR is, if we compare major economies of the world, SLR is only there in India. You can rest in the Central Bank of United States or Bank of England in England. So they don't have any terminology or any concept called as SLR, which is statutory liquidity ratio. Okay, they only have a concept of CRR. Okay, the terminologies may change, but each and every bank has to keep some deposits with the Central Bank of that country in order to be get the benefits or get the regulations followed. So utna hi hai. So after this, I'll do with commercial banks and the future of banking applications and all those things, and we'll complete the first module, and maybe in the next class. Okay, so shall I close the class?